Hello, and welcome back to another episode of Your Drone Questions Answered. I'm John Dickow, here to answer your drone questions, or at the very least, find the person who can. This week, we're answering the question, what is a good alternative to a DJI drone? Today, I have with me Sally French. She is the drone girl of thedronegirl.com. Sally, thanks for being back to talk with me again.
Thanks for having me. I'm always happy to be here.
So first, I'm really curious myself, why would somebody be looking for an alternative to DJI in the first place?
Yeah, so I sort of put this on three different reasons. The first is simply because a lot of people want to buy American. It doesn't even have to do with drones, but there's a reason why people love Levi's jeans. People want to buy that product that's made in America, often no matter what it is, which could simply be patriotism, wanting to keep the money in our country and keep our economy strong. The second reason has to do with anti-China sentiment specifically. We've seen a lot of legislation recently that has suggested possible bans on DJI drones. And typically these bans don't apply to consumer drones, but what we've seen is a lot of proposals that would prohibit federal agencies from using drones from certain countries, which is namely China. And as you probably know, DJI is a Chinese company. So a lot of these bans would even prevent some federal agencies, but that aren't necessarily military side agencies. I'm talking about things like NOAA, the National Oceanic Atmospheric Administration. You know, they're using drones for things like tracking weather, tracking whales. Even they might be prohibited from using drones. And often, if they're prohibited from using drones, a lot of companies that are privately held also just don't want to use DJI drones, because if they're then contracted by, say, NOAA, then they wouldn't be able to use those drones either. And so that's a reason why people are looking for non-DJI or non-Chinese products. We haven't actually seen a ton of legislation actually passed. However, there have been a lot of proposals of recent legislation. There was just one in February 2023 called the American Security Drone Act. So those are all things to keep in mind. The third reason is simply because I think there's a lot of people who want to be an iconoclast and want to have something different from the crowd. The people who have some random phone you've never heard of just because they don't want to have an iPhone like everybody else. So that's just sort of my last reason why people might be looking for a non-DJI product.
Okay, well, interesting. Thank you for that context. And when I kind of look at the market, DJI is everywhere. And it's not even just in the drone market. I work in video and they make all kinds of cameras that even I use at work. I guess that leads to the meat of our question is, what are good alternatives to DJI drones? And are there good alternatives to DJI drones?
Yeah, the reality is there are not a ton of good alternatives to DJI drones, and even the alternatives there are tend to still be Chinese made. So I do want to sort of put in context your question and sort of pin down what we're talking about. So the reality is, in the many thousands of dollars realm, there are tons of alternatives. In fact, there are many American drone companies, but the drones that they're producing are typically in, you know, the $10,000, the $50,000 realm. These are big enterprise products. So if someone's looking for an American-made drone to, you know, do spraying for agriculture or to do thermal assessments, they probably have an option. Where things get really challenging is when people are looking for maybe a camera drone. They're, you know, a talented photographer and they want a non-DJI product, and maybe their budget is under $2,000. That's sort of like a reasonable camera drone budget for more professional photographer. It's going to be really hard to find something under $2,000. What's even harder is the people who say my budget is like $500. DJI, as you mentioned, is everywhere and they create tons of amazing products for every price point. You can look at something like a DJI mini drone and find something under $500. But to find a non-DJI product and even a non-Chinese product for less than $500, that's going to be really difficult.
Wow. And it sounds like it's almost affects people more on the consumer level than it would be, say, on any company. And obviously for companies have their reason, even politically, why they probably can't or wouldn't want to use DJI, but that really hits the consumer level pretty hard.
Yeah. Yeah. And, you know, going back to what we were talking about, a lot of the people who really want those American products or who maybe legally can't use a Chinese made product, that would be on the enterprise level. I do think there are a lot of misconceptions that people hear that Congress wants to ban DJI drones. And that's like the extent of the headline. But Congress wants to ban DJI drones from being used by federal agencies. So if you're just someone who says, I like to go out sailing and I like to film my boat adventures with a drone and I post my videos on YouTube, you don't need to worry about this. You can still use a DJI drone. The question is, you know, if you don't want to use a DJI drone for maybe personal reasons, for patriotic reasons, because you are that iconoclast, that's where I say, you know what, you don't really have a ton of options.
Okay. And it seems like there's even some sticky parts where you're looking for certain replacements and certain companies, they may not have DJI in the name, but they use certain parts. And if you're kind of that person who's really patriotic or religiously not trying to use DJI, that could be another issue.
Yeah, you know, then we see this in literally every industry. What buy American truly means is pretty sticky. And there are sort of like levels of definitions of what a product needs to have, what it needs to entail to be considered made in America. And we see this in clothes. If it was designed in America and it was put together in America, but the fabric or the thread came from somewhere else, are you able to call that an American made product? And it really depends on who you ask and what you're classifying it as. And of course, we see this with drones. There's so many parts. There's batteries, there's boards. There's all these pieces that come together, and it's highly unlikely literally all of it is going to be made in America. Again, that's just something to keep in mind.
So despite all this, there's really doesn't seem to be a whole lot out there in terms of alternatives. For the person who submitted this question, is there anything you can tell them that might be a path forward or something that they might be able to rely on?
What's their budget?
Ooh, good question. I'm just going to make it up. Let's just say it's under $1,000.
Under $1,000? Okay, well, so this is also where things get sticky. I would easily recommend the Skydio 2 drone. This drone starts at $999, putting you exactly at the $1,000 threshold. And it's a crash-proof, follow-me drone, a really incredible piece of tech, especially for the product. Skydio is made in California, but here lies the problem. Actually, just a few months ago, we noticed that Skydio's consumer drones went out of stock. It's been a few months and they're still out of stock. I actually reached out to Skydio and I said, hey, what's up? And they gave a pretty vague PR answer, basically to the effect of, we'll keep you updated. So it seems like there is not just a clear, like, we had a backlog of X part, but we expect to get it in by this fall, so we'll be producing more this fall. It was a little too vague, which makes me nervous. Skydio in recent years has been leaning into the enterprise, the commercial side of things, and I don't want to speculate, but if you're going to force me to, I almost wonder if Skydio is getting out of the consumer drone business and leaning all in on commercial and enterprise, which the reality is that's probably where there's way more money. Anyway, so unfortunately, my top pick is out of stock, but you might be able to buy it used on a third party. So I would recommend if you want that drone, jump on it now.
Well, that's a good tip. What if I raise the cost bar a little bit? What if I went up to like 2,000 or even beyond? What does any options open up?
Yeah, there are slightly more options and not necessarily made in America. But one thing that I would really recommend that people look for is the Sony Air Peak drone. This drone recently came out and it's been constantly improving. So the Sony Air Peak drone was designed to carry the Sony Alpha series of cameras. Sony is a Japanese camera maker, and I'm sure you know their cameras are top of the line. There are so many people who say we want to carry these incredible cameras. And so Sony made their own drone that can carry these cameras and integrate them. The problem is you'll have to have the camera to begin with, which is going to be many thousands of dollars likely. And then the drone itself costs about $4,000. So that's going to be for someone who's really on sort of that high-end photography spectrum. So maybe someone who works in Hollywood to make films. There's another American-made drone company, speaking of Sony cameras. It's called Skyfish, and they're based in Montana, and they make a drone, and it's designed specifically to carry that Sony Alpha series. So again, if you already have the Sony camera and you're looking for a way to carry it and you don't want to use the Japanese-made Air Peak from Sony, you could use the Skyfish drone, which is made in America.
Interesting. Okay. And I mean, I'm just thinking about this now too, is as drones become more and more a part of businesses, everyday hobby use, and just seems to be more accepted than say it would be 10 years ago. I'm kind of surprised that there aren't more drone options out there. Does DJI really just have such a firm grasp on the market when it comes to consumer level cheaper drones?
Yes, they absolutely do. And there have been so many companies that have tried and failed. I will give you one more sort of side note is Autel is an alternative to DJI. The reason why they don't super stand out is because they are also made in China. So if your goal is simply to avoid Chinese made drones, Autel has always very closely followed DJI. Pretty much whatever DJI makes, Autel makes like a knockoff version. So this started early on with their Autel X-Star. It literally looked exactly like a DJI Phantom, except it was orange. And to be frank, it performed just as well as a DJI Phantom, sometimes even better. And ever since then, they pretty much just copied DJI products. So their new Nano and Evo drones really closely resemble the Mavic line. So I will add Autel as an alternative. But to answer your question about the other camera drone makers, there have been many that have tried and they've failed. So taking a step back, one company that people really fell for and fell in love with was a company called 3D Robotics. They promised to make a drone called the Iris, and they later created a drone called the Solo. And that company got $100 million in investor funding. They were a media darling for being this company that could compete, maybe even take down DJI. They had many management issues, and also just the cost of competing with DJI is difficult. So they managed to burn through their $100 million and they hardly exist now. But even other greater established companies, we saw GoPro try to make a drone. So they are famous for their action cameras. They have a ton of capital. They have a ton of experience. They know how to make cameras. And they said, you know what? People are putting GoPros on drones, so why don't we make our own drone? They created the Karma drone, which retailed for $799, which would, again, put us under that hypothetical $1,000 budget. But that drone had a lot of production issues. It had a lot of challenges, and it didn't last too long. Ultimately, they just ceased production because it was too difficult to actually make the drone. There are so many other examples. There was something called the Lily drone that promised to be made in America. That drone completely failed, was a Kickstarter product. And so the reality is it's expensive to produce products in America. Wages are higher. The infrastructure of factories isn't there the way it is in Asia. And so all these companies that try to say we can make an American drone that's appealing at, you know, that $1,000 or $2,000 price point, it's just so hard to do, coupled with the fact that DJI already does it great, for the most part, makes it just really difficult for any competition to come in.
Well, very interesting, Sally. And I wonder, you know, maybe another 10 years down the line, it doesn't sound like the relationship with China is getting any better, if that might eventually free up some bandwidth for more options to come out there. But I guess that'd be purely speculation and also having to do a lot with legislation and stuff like that.
Yeah, we do see so many growing companies in America on the commercial end, and the technology is new. I think there is some hope that once we nail it in the commercial end, it'll seep into the consumer end. And we see this with, you know, all sorts of products. Things started as a military technology, and then now they're part of everyday life. Things started as some big commercial technology. I mean, even think about, you know, computers in, you know, the 80s, you would never have a computer in your house. It would only be this high level thing that the biggest organizations had. And then now everyone not only has a computer in their house, but if you are willing to consider your iPhone a computer, everyone has a computer in their literal pocket. And so it could take time for this technology to then seep down to the consumer level and be affordable again. What's interesting about drones is it almost started as a consumer product from DJI, and it started affordably. Then all these things happened and it became a big enterprise technology, and we might need to go back around the circle for it to become again affordable when it comes to American-made drones that appear in everyone's pockets as well.
Very interesting. Well, thank you. Any other last thoughts? I know we're kind of running down on time here.
This was a great discussion. I always love talking about the trials and tribulations of American drone companies.
Well, it's great insight, too. And there is. It's kind of funny now how drones have gotten caught up now in things like politics and legislation. It'll be interesting to see where things go in the future.
Absolutely.
Well, thank you so much, Sally, for joining us. Sally French, thedronegirl.com. You can visit that website anytime. She has awesome tips on there, amazing articles, especially if you're out there looking for a drone on the consumer level. I've visited there myself. I recommended a drone to my dad and he bought it by reading one of her articles. So highly recommend it. In the meantime, for anybody watching, anybody listening, you can submit your own drone questions. We'd be happy to find the answer to it. You can visit ydqa.io, or if you're part of the Drone Launch Academy private community, Drone Launch Connect, send us a message through there and we'll take it. We will find the answer for you and we'll put it on this podcast. In the meantime, we'll see you in the sky.